case statement by Minister Dr. Harshavardhan to make a statement. In fact, I was thinking to request you to lay it on the table, but having seen the subject, which is very favorite for me, I want you to read it.
Thank you, sir.
Clarification later.
Later,
not today.
Not today, but later it will be.
But listen to this, this is very, very.
That's why, sir, later you kindly permit us to.
Yeah. Clarification will be later. Yes.
Chairman, sir, and honorable members, I wish to bring to the attention of this house a development in the field of science and technology in the world, which is of most profound importance for the future of not only India, its economy and society, but also the survival of the human civilization, which is threatened by over-exploitation of nature and climate change. Last night at 11:24 p.m., Ahmedabad witnessed the historic landing of the world's first solar-powered aircraft, which began a global tour on Monday, the March 11. This aircraft, named Solar Impulse 2, SI-2, is capable of flying day and night on only solar power. It is on a mission to spread information about the fantastic possibilities of life free of fossil fuels. Its success will serve to convince all humanity that the sun is the supreme source of energy with limitless powers. It is also the major source of power which renews itself every day and forever. Honorable members of the House, as the country's Minister for Science and Technology, I feel it is my honor to congratulate the scientists, technicians, publicists, and last but not the least, the two pilots of SI-2, Mr. Bertrand Piccard and Mr. André Bosberg, for their commitment and dedication to the vision of a cleaner and greener world. I think the entire community of Indian scientists working on the making solar power cheaper and more efficient are greatly enthused by SI-2's landing in our country. The plane is made entirely of carbon fiber and has a wingspan of 226 feet, but it weighs only 2.3 tons. It is almost as big as an Airbus A380, which is currently the biggest aircraft powered by fossil fuels, but about 250 times lighter. SI-2 carries more than 17,000 photovoltaic cells rated at 66 kilowatts peak. At present, its maximum speed is about 140 kilometers per hour, which is as fast as a fighter plane of the World War I. Chairman, sir, through you, I wish to urge every honorable member present here to carry the message ingrained to the SI-2 mission. Recognize and celebrate Surya Shakti, the power of the sun. The significance of Ahmedabad as choice of first landing in India should not be missed. It is the capital of Gujarat, the state that has pioneered large-scale harnessing and distribution of solar energy for everyday use. In 2009, Gujarat became the first state in India and Asia to have established a Department of Climate Change to counter the threat to the planet posed by overuse of fossil fuels. Shri Narendra Modi ji, who was then the Chief Minister, made the Gujarat Solar Park the largest hub of solar power generation in Asia, currently producing more than 1,000 megawatts. Now, as Prime Minister, Shri Modi ji has set sights on India generating 100 gigawatts of solar power by 2022. Chairman, sir, I am sure that all those who believe this is impossible will be persuaded otherwise by the presence today in our midst of SI-2 and its courageous crew and team members. The SI-2 flight's landing in India serves to persuade those who still harbor misgivings on the possibilities of solar power. This may not result in aircraft companies manufacturing solar-based planes overnight, but that is bound to happen within the next 10 to 15 years. But before that, we must ensure that coal, oil, wood, and all traditional forms of energy for daily needs become history. I thank the government of Switzerland.
Please, please.
Use oil will be history.
Please, please.
I thank the government of Switzerland and the large number of R&D and business organizations, both Indian as well as foreign, that have made SI2 possible. Their aircraft and its crew are expected to take off for Varanasi on March 15. After that, it will fly to Myanmar and then to China. Its biggest feat would be to cross the Pacific Ocean to the United States and then the Atlantic Ocean to Europe. On behalf of the entire scientific community of India and this house, I wish the project all success. Thank you.
Yeah, this is a very great achievement of science. I would recommend that all the honorable members in their residential home should start using solar energy. See, yes, it's in my house also, in Kerala, I am using solar energy for all lighting purpose. It is not that costly also, and once you install, it will last for years, 20, 24 years. So we should all start and we should be example to others. That is the cleanest energy, and this achievement is a great achievement for mankind, and I am very happy that the minister came and found it necessary to come with a statement here. I thank the minister for this. For this statement.